I found this really cool looking facade online and thought, well, how do we do something like this in Revit? I did some testing and found a way to do it using some adaptive components and creating this parametrically. So now I'm going to be showing you the entire process from start to finish, step by step. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out our website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. We are an Autodesk authorized training center and we offer over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. I'm at the home screen, so I'm going to start modeling this as a family. So we're just going to be doing one single facade module as an adaptive component. So to do that, you need to go here to families, go to new, and here I'm just going to jump back one step and go to English metric, and then I'm going to search for the generic ones. And here we have the generic model adaptive. This is the one you want to pick, or of course use Imperial if you prefer Imperial units. So now, as soon as Revit opens up this family, what we need to do now is just kind of set things up by placing 4 points. This is going to have 4 corners. So you go here to point element and you set 4 points for each of those corners. Now, these are simple empty points. We're just going to select all 4 of them, click to make adaptive, and now these are adaptive points. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select 2 points and then go to spline through points, and then I'm also going to click on is reference. And now I'm just going to repeat this for the rest of the points. Once we have this frame created, now it's time to extrude it up. So we need to have some points that are above the existing ones. So I'm going to do that by clicking again on the point element. Then I'm going to go here to set work plane, and I'm just going to pick the work plane of this adaptive point, just like that. Then I'm going to use a point, use the draw on face option here, zoom in and then click on that point. Now, once you hit the escape key a couple of times, I can click on that point and move it up just like this. Now, when I click on this point and move it around, I just want to make sure that the point above it is going to be moving with it. This is the kind of adaptive part of this family, and this needs to be working. As you can see, it's working. So now I'm just going to be repeating this for each of the remaining 3 points. Now, once we have all of them created, we want to control the elevation of all of these points at once with a single parameter. Now, what you'll notice is that here, when I select this point, you're going to see that here in the properties panel, we have the offset parameter, and it's currently set to 1800 millimeters. Now, I'm just going to click on this little button, which is going to allow me to associate an existing parameter or create a new one. I'm just going to create a new one and call it the main offset. I'm going to make this an instance parameter and then just click OK. OK again. And now this is parametric. You can see that this is grayed out over here and it has this equals number. Now I'm just going to select this point, go to the same offset, click on this button and just pick the main offset. And then I'm just going to repeat that for the remaining 2 points. Once this is done, let's now assign a proper number here. So I'm just going to go to family types. And then here in the family types, we have that parameter and let's make it 1000 millimeters, hit apply, okay, and this is what we have. Now I'm just going to move the whole thing a little bit in to make it a bit more compact, just to match what I'm trying to do, just like that. Okay, looks good. We can fix it up a little bit to make it a bit more squarish, but yeah. Okay, now let's move forward. Now we're just going to be connecting the top points and turning them into reference planes, just like we did with the bottom points. Once we now have the main frame in place, now we can start to offset this to the inside to create the actual 3D skeleton. So for that, I want to create another set of 4 points offset to the inside. So what I'll do now is just go here to the point element, again, go to set work plane, and I'm going to set the horizontal work plane of this first point and place another point just a little bit on the inside and just repeat that for the following 3 points. Now, once we have these in place, what you'll notice is that they can kind of move with these existing points, but they sometimes might not move. So we want to make sure that they are placed correctly, and we also want to make sure we can control the offset. But before that, let's just connect these four with spline through points and make them reference. Now we're going to be using some dimensions in order to control the position of these inner points. You do that by going here to align the dimension, just like that. You go to the vertical reference plane here, and then to the point itself and place it. Then to this one, to the point itself, and then you place that. And now I'm just going to repeat this for the rest of the points. Once we have placed all of these, now let's select all of the dimensions. I'm just going to make a broad selection, go here to filter, and then check none and just pick dimensions. Hit apply, okay. And now I'm going to go to label, create a new parameter, and I'm just going to call this one the bottom offset. Make it an instance parameter and then click okay. Now we have basically the same distance from all points. However, I'm just going to go here to the family types and make sure that I set it to something like 300, for example. Hit apply. Okay, and now that looks really, really good. Now I want to repeat that for the points up here. Now the problem is they don't really have the reference planes at the moment. See how these have the reference planes? These don't. So what you need to do for that is you need to select these four points on top, just like that. Then you need to go here to graphics, show reference planes, and then go to always, hit apply. Okay, and now what you'll notice is it's still not going to show it, but if you go close to it with a dimension, as you can see, now it's going to show it. Also, if I go with this point and want to set a work plane, yeah, so I can set it up like that. Okay, so now I'm just going to use the same approach I used on the bottom to place additional offset points on the top. Okay, now once we have this in place, I'm just going to hold the control key and select all of the upper dimensions that we have placed here. So let's see. Okay, I have missed one dimension here, so let's do that now quickly. Okay, so now I'm just going to hold the control key, select these dimensions just like that, go to parameter, label, create new parameter, and let's call this one the top offset. Make it an instance parameter, click OK, and there we go. Now I'm just going to open up the family types, and then let's set the top offset to 100 millimeters, hit apply, OK, and now as you can see, it's a bit smaller on top and a bit wider on the bottom. Now we need to turn this into actual geometry. So how do we do that? Well, we're just going to create one cube from the outer lines and then create a void with the inner lines. So let me show you how that works. You select the outer ring on the bottom, hold the control key, select the outer ring on top, and go to create form. Now we have a form, then select the inner ring on the top, hold the control key, select the inner ring on the bottom, and then go to create form and go with a void form. And now we get something that looks like this. Really cool. Now hover over the edge of the form, hit the tab key once or a few times until you highlight the entire thing. Then go here to the material, and now let's find some sort of a white material for this. I'm just going to go down here through the library. Yeah, let's go with this white laminate. That's going to look nice. There we go. So now we have created this adaptive family. As you can see, we can kind of move this thing around and it's not going to break. Oops, I did manage to break it. So let's go back. Yeah, I guess I have to be a bit more careful not to move the dimensions or anything. Okay, there we go. So once we have this in place, now let's go here to file, new, and then start a new project, or you can just start a conceptual mass, whichever you prefer. Now here for this mass, I'm just going to go back and use the metric units. So just conceptual mass like that, open it up. And then here, I'm simply going to go with a line, create a line just like that, hit the escape key a couple of times, select it, go to create form, and then select the top line and move it up just like this. Okay, so once we have this, let's say this is our facade. What we can do now is just select the entire facade, then go to divide surface. Here, let's change the U grid to 12. Let's see what that does. Let's go with 14. I'm just trying to make this kind of squarish. Yeah, that works. And then I'm going to go to surface repetition, click on this little arrow, and then go to nodes and turn those on. Now, with that, we have basically these nodes at the intersections of these lines, which we're going to be using now. Okay, once we have this in place, we can go to our family. We can save this, so let's call it the adaptive facade element. Save, then load into project. And now once it's loaded, as you can see, it's going to look like this. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go to create, go to component, and then start placing this. So I can start off from this point here to this point, to this point, and then to this point, and it's going to create that shape. Now what you're going to notice that sometimes this shape is going to seem a bit crooked and a bit off. So here, as you can see, I think I've missed with that second point. So let's try that again. And also I've noticed that these two points are visible. So you can actually turn those off. When you go here to the family, you can highlight the point. Okay, this one isn't, but one is probably set to visible. So that's what's giving us the issues. Let's see, is it this one? Okay, so it's this one. See, if I make it invisible, and this one as well, that should fix the problem. So now I'm just going to load that into the project, override, and as you can see, it's no longer visible, those purple points. So I'm just going to delete this one. Let's try again. So create component, and then go from this point here to this point, to this node, to this node. Okay, now it's looking really good. I can also switch this to realistic, should give us that white color. There we go. And also we can play around with the dimensions. So let's say I want the bottom offset to be 400. So it's just going to make it a bit larger. There we go. And now we want to repeat this on the entire facade. Now I could have done this with just a curtain element that's going to adapt, but that's not going to give us the full functionality. The reason why I went with this is because now I can multiply this. So you multiply it by selecting it and then going here to repeat. And it's just going to repeat it across the entire facade. But then what you can do is you can use the tab key to highlight individual points like this. And now I'm just selecting multiple points. Now I'm just going to select a few. And now I can delete these. Okay, I have this one left. Let's delete that one as well. Okay, so now once I have created this empty space, I can place in a larger component. So if I just go here to component, I just place it the same way I did the rest. So I just go 1, 2, let's see, 3, oops, and then 4. Just like that. And now we have one larger component. You can also play around with its offset. So for example, I'm going to make the top offset 300 and the bottom offset 800, for example. And now it's going to be just a bit larger. And that's how that's going to look like. And now you can play around with this facade and create all sorts of shapes on top of this facade just by using this adaptive component. Of course, you can take it even further, add some glass, make it like a curtain panel or something like that. But this is basically the approach you want to use for creating facades like this. Now, if you would like to learn more about adaptive components in Revit, I have an entire course on adaptive components, and I also have an entire course on masking in Revit. So those two courses are on balkanarchitect.com. The link is up in the cards above and also in the description of this video. So check them out. Also, if you don't want to do the work and you just want to get these components, they are going to be available on our Patreon page. So the link to that is also up in the cards above and down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.